And this is getting interesting. I invite you to pay keen attention. Beyond the money, beyond the life, what I invite you to consider is, would it be near good or near right to say that attention is very limited in us? Would it be a possibility, would it be true for me to throw it here and say that our attention is very limited? Would it? Think about it.
No.
Right now you could be looking at me, but perhaps your mind is not here. Ashafika China. Can you imagine? Labda vera baga for things. Alas, as you say. So our mind tends to move and think about thoughts, 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 thoughts. Just like a monkey, someone says. Monkey is such a great animal, right? It jumps and jumps and jumps and plays and eats banana. I don't think our minds eat banana, but one thing I know with my mind is it thinks and thinks and thinks and thinks and so many thoughts. And sometimes these thoughts create the books we write, they create the poems we write, which is very useful. But most times in my experience, these thoughts also create a lot of frustrations for us. They also create a lot of disconnect between us in a way that I'm talking to you, but I'm not listening. I get this a lot in my life. Then if you're not listening, I'm like, yeah, I was doing it. I should be listening. I'm even practicing meditation. Okay, no. So there is a lot of attention issues. And for me, what I invite in this space is perhaps we can pay more attention. And pay more attention to things like this conversation, to life, as Paulette said, and most importantly, to our life, to bring different elements of what life really means for us.